Hi everyone, welcome back to Herky the Cavalier's channel. I'm here today with... Oh, you guys switched places? I'm here today with Herky and Milton, and we are in the LA bedroom right now, and I thought I would just change up the setting of it to make it a bit more enjoyable for you to watch different settings. And today I wanted to talk about a subject that a lot of you have requested, and I thought this would be super helpful for any of you getting a new puppy. I know a lot of you want to get puppies or are recently new pet owners, and I thought I would do a roundup of 10 things you should expect when getting a new puppy. Now, by all means, I'm not a dog expert by any means. I just have experience with Herky and Milton, and as a first-time dog owner myself, I learned a lot along the way, and I just wanted to share that knowledge with you in order to help you along the way. There's some things that I should have expected, but I did not expect, so I hope this video does help you guys out. Before you get into the video, I do want to remind you to like this video if you like it, subscribe, and we really appreciate you guys' support. You guys are so amazing. We love you so much. So let's get onto the video. So the first thing I would tell you to expect when you have a new puppy is that they will test your patience. A new puppy is all about patience, and you have to do your best to remain calm and be consistent and be patient, because not everything is gonna happen overnight. I'm telling you guys, puppies are hard. They require a lot of energy, a lot of patience. And although Herky and Milton are very well behaved now, it wasn't always the case, I'm telling you. So just do your best, just be consistent and patient, and everything that you want will eventually come. I promise you, it's just not easy. I'm pretty sure it's like being a new parent, you know? It's not easy, but everybody does it. Everybody goes through it, but you just have to be very patient and very consistent. The second thing I would tell you to expect when you get a new puppy is that it costs money to have a puppy. During the first year especially, you're gonna have a lot of vet visits to get all the booster shots. You need a monthly budget for food, for toys, for treats, etc. So just make sure that you're aware of the fact that you will have added expenses when you have a puppy. There's nothing more devastating than people that get puppies and that realize that, you know, puppies cost too much, and then they end up just giving the puppy away. That just breaks my heart. So just make sure that when you get a puppy, you know that it's a commitment. You know that you will see that commitment through, because we don't like to see puppies being abandoned. Like, not that it costs that much to have a puppy. I would tell you that Herky and Milton together, their food budget per month is about $80 to $100 per month for both dogs. So if you have one dog, maybe it will cost you $40, $50 per month. Like, it's not that much money. As for treats and toys, I mean, their treats last so long. So you buy a bag of treats, it's probably going to cost you $10 to $15. It's going to last you a few months. Then for toys, if your dog is not too much of a shredder, you can just rotate some toys and get some ones that last a bit longer. If you guys want maybe an updated video about treats, toys, chews, anything that I recommend for puppies, do let me know, and I will certainly and gladly do that video for you. But other than that food budget, you will have those vet visits that you have to consider. And of course, you have to keep in mind that you can get some vet visits unexpectedly, and those can, you know, add up to the budget that you had in place for your puppy. Third point, I would say, all puppies are different. You can hear a lot of things, you can read a lot of things about puppies, about how they are, how they behave, but they will all be different. And the biggest example, I would say, is Herky and Milton couldn't be more difficult. They couldn't be more different as puppies. Herky was super difficult as a puppy. She had massive puppy crazes all the time. She was very hard, and she tested her patience to the max, but Milton, it was very different. So you can read and prepare a lot of things, but then there's a lot of unexpected that will happen also, just because puppies tend to be different. So if, let's say, you read some things about puppies and then you get your puppy and he or she is a bit different, then you may have to adjust certain things in order to adjust to your puppy's personality. Fourth point is, I need to remind everybody of this, is that puppies grow up so fast, like so incredibly fast, you have no idea. Like, they could wake up from a nap and you'll see a difference, honestly. So the biggest thing I would tell you is that you should take tons of photos and videos to have the most puppy memories as possible, because they grow up so fast. And that's the one regret I have with Herky, is that even though I told myself to take tons of photos and videos, I don't have that much from her. Milton has a lot more, so I just wish that I had done that more, and I should have expected just how fast that they grow up. Fifth point I would say is that the puppy energy is for real. Oh my god, they are so real. But again, all puppies are different. But Herky's puppy energy was so real, and oof, my god, she is gonna test you. And they really have the puppy crazy sometimes, especially sometimes, okay? Herky really got crazy, like the more tired she would get, the more crazy she would be. You know, it's like a cranky baby. When the baby's tired, it gets really cranky and then it gets a bit crazy. Then puppies can be the same. Point number six, I would say, is that potty training requires work and it's not always easy. Accidents will happen and you just have to be really patient with it. Accidents will happen, like no matter what. Milton had accidents up until like a month ago. No, I'm kidding. Like she is potty trained, but she still had an accident like last month or something. But Herky was pretty easy to potty train, but there's still some instances where there was some pee and some poo in the house. Sometimes it's our fault. But you just have to remember to be consistent, be patient, don't be mean to your puppy when there's an accident in the house because they just don't understand. So it's your job as a pet parent to show them the right way. But don't worry, when pees happen in the house, it's all good, it's all part of the process. And while we're talking about pee accidents, the number one thing I would recommend is enzymatic spray. I will link it down in the description box below. When there's accidents, pee or poo in the house, you do want to clean it up with some enzymatic spray in order for it to break down the smell of the pee and poo. Otherwise, if you just clean it with any sort of other product, your dog can still smell the pee and poo. And he or she is going to think that that is a proper potty area. So you want to make sure that all that smell is gone. Next point, this kind of falls into the budget thing. But you should really look into pet insurance. I wish I would have had pet insurance for Herky when she was younger, just to have it on file. Like the sooner you get your puppy on some pet insurance, the lower the premium will be each month. You can shop around for all the different brands, but we are currently with Trupanion. The reason why I chose Trupanion is because they have a really good reputation and I've read a lot of reviews and this is what seemed to work best for our needs. The premium is a bit more expensive than other companies on a monthly basis, but what I personally wanted was a no cap insurance. So for example, the previous company we were on, they capped it at $1,500 per illness per year. So $1,500 per illness or per accident per year is really not a lot, according to me. You can barely get anything done with that amount. So what I wanted was something that had no cap. So we pay 10%, the company pays 90%, but we have no cap. So for example, for an accident that would require, for example, knee injury, that can cost up to like $7,000. So this is something that fit better for our needs. But feel free to shop any insurance that would fit your needs. But this is something great in order to cover like the unexpected. I would highly recommend it. Point number nine is that you should expect... Why is there so many helicopters?
You girl, that's little fatty babies.
Point number nine, I would say, is that you should expect training and a lot of socialization happening between the age of 3-4 months. Herky, we didn't socialize until she had all her puppy shots, which was about at the 4-month mark. That kind of affected her socialization. Milton is so much more social as a dog towards other dogs. And I think that is because we socialized her like right when we got her, there was already Herky. And so socialization is super important around the 3-month mark, I would say. And this is totally personal because a lot of pet parents and me included at the time, I really wanted to wait until Herky had her full vaccination before exposing her to other dogs. But on the flip side, I think that affected her socialization quite a bit. So that is totally optional, but that is something you should consider. And also training. I would start training as soon as you get the puppy because that is when their brains are like sponges. And that is the optimal time to start training and anything that you want it to be a repetition. So you should start leash training, you should start basic obedience, you should start teeth brushing just so that they get used to it. So the sooner you start with everything, the better it's going to be in the long run for your dog to get used to. Right when you get your puppy, you can even start by little commands to make them understand their name, sit, stay, down. All those commands are really basic things that you can start teaching your dog as soon as you get them at about 9 to 10 weeks old. And then last but not least, you should expect that there will be a lot of new situations in which you're gonna say, WTF do I do? Honestly, it happened to us so much and you can read and you can research and you can prepare, but there's a lot of situations where you're gonna be like, what do I do? The biggest thing for us was like diarrhea or when they cough weird, they make a weird sound. You're gonna get really paranoid about a lot of things, but just know that there's a huge dog community on YouTube, on Instagram, on Facebook that you can get a lot of information from. And you can also call your vet at any time you want. Personally, our vet is open 24 hours a day with a line that you can call a vet technician to get some questions answered. But just know that you will eventually always get an answer to what you want. So new situations in which you don't know what to do, they will happen, and it's totally normal. And don't put that pressure on yourself to know everything, because new situations will arise all the time. I know I got super paranoid when I didn't know what it was, but it's the reverse sneezing, and the sound is terrifying. And once when you don't know what something is, you're gonna get really scared. But eventually it will all work out, so don't put too much pressure on yourself. So that is it for our video for today. If you have any questions, please leave them down below and we'll do our best to answer everything. I really hope you enjoyed this video and it will help you if you're a new dog owner or if you're planning on getting another puppy. So thank you guys so much for watching. We love you and we'll see you soon.